Hi everyone. This tutorial is about the program Structure Comparison. Structure Comparison is a tool for the analysis of near-identical protein structures, such as models from different crystal forms, various mutants, or NCS-related copies. It displays validation outliers and regions of difference in tables. The GUI is linked to CUT and PyMOL for easy visualization. To run Structure Comparison, at least two or more related protein chains are required. It is possible to use separate files or NCS-related copies in a single file. Optionally, diffraction data or pre-calculated map coefficients can be provided so that maps can be shown in addition to the protein chains. The data for this tutorial are available from the example datasets which come with the Phenix installation. To set up the example data, open the Phenix GUI and click on New Project. Then, choose Setup Tutorial Data. In the new window, open the drop-down menu next to Tutorial Data. Go down to Other and choose the dataset in the middle, called Protein Kinase A, Structure Comparison. Choose a directory and then click OK. To run Structure Comparison, choose Validation and then click on Structure Comparison, which opens a new window. For bookkeeping, add a job title. To add files, either the Add File, Add Directory or Add Directory Tree button can be used. Add File opens files one by one. Add Directory opens a pair of files, such as a model and a data file in a directory. And Add Directory Tree searches for file pairs by walking through a directory tree. As there are many files in the tutorial directory, let's choose Add Directory. The directory contains six model files, which are now listed in the input file window, along with the corresponding data files. The sequence file, which is at the bottom, is used to define the reference chain. An important choice is whether to superpose the structures onto the reference. If this option is enabled, all similar chains and the density maps are superposed onto the reference. The results of the comparison are the same, but the graphics window will show all chains superposed. Let's activate the superposition for this example and then click Run to start the program. If diffraction data were provided, maps are calculated, which can be time-consuming. Therefore, if files with map coefficients are available, it is recommended to use them instead. When the run is finished, several new tabs appear which summarize the results of the different analyses. Let's start with the Summary tab. In the left column is a list of the chains matching the reference. For example, chain E of model 1L3R matches chain A and B of model 1SYK. The table then lists the number of atoms and residues, the sequence identity in percent, the average isotropic B factor, and the RMSD if superposition was enabled. Click on the Show CUT Controls button. In the CUT Control window, click Load Models and Maps to open a CUT session with the superposed models and maps. We will look more closely at the structures in a moment, but let's first continue with the result tabs. The Ligand Summary tab lists similar properties for all ligands present in the chains to be compared. Note that columns are sortable. The items in the table can be, for example, sorted according to the number of atoms. The next table shows the rotamer angle differences. Any set of equivalent residues with multiple rotamer classes, or outliers, will be displayed. Let's have a look at residue lysine 309. The rotamer is identified as outlier, highlighted in red, in model 3DND. The cell for model 1L3R is gray, which means this residue is missing or incomplete. If more than half of the side chains for common residues have the same rotamer, the cell is highlighted in green, which is the case for chains A and B of model NSYK and chain E of model 3FJQ. The rotamer IDs, MTTT in this example, are taken from a study published by Lovell et al. The reference can be found in the description of this video. Minority conformations are highlighted in orange, as for chains A in model 3FHI and 3DNE. Note also that the rotamer ID of the latter is written in italics, which means this is an allowed rotamer, which only occurs in 0.3 to 2% of residues. The summary table below can serve as a legend for the cell colors. For lysine 309, there is one outlier, three favored rotamers, one minority favored and one minority allowed rotamer, and one residue has missing atoms. Now double-click on the cell marked outlier, which will center on this residue in the Coot window. Let's focus on the rotamers of 3DND and 3DNE and hide all other maps and models. The sidechains point to the right, partly covered with negative difference density, while there is 2f ops minus f calc and positive difference density on the left. The orientation of these sidechains can be most likely improved by trying to fit them better to the density. It can be also noted that the sidechain of lysine 309 in 3FJQ also points to the left. Therefore, the rotamer table can help identifying regions which need further attention. The results of the other tabs are represented similarly, so let's go a bit quicker through them. The Ramachandran table shows any set of residues with outliers or multiple Ramachandran angles. The cells contain the values of the angles. The missing atoms table displays missing atoms or residues. The cell lists which atoms are missing. Note that the cell can be expanded to see all the atom names. The secondary structure table shows any set of matching residues with more than one type of secondary structure assignment. For example, a residue labeled as a beta sheet in one chain and without assignment in another chain. The water results table lists water molecules and ions which are not conserved in all chains. For example, the first column shows that there are a magnesium ion, two manganese ions, and one water molecule at equivalent positions in four of the chains, while there is no water in three of the chains. Similarly, the ligand information table shows if there are ligands at equivalent positions. The B-factor tab shows the per-residue average isotropic B-factor. It can be used to identify regions with higher B-factors, which can represent larger mobility or reflect modeling errors. Result tabs only appear if there are differences between chains. This is why the following two result tabs do not appear for the protein kinase example. Omega angle analysis. Omega angles are categorized as trans, cis, or twisted. Any matching residues with different assignments are displayed in the results table. Histidine protonation. The histidine sidechain can have three different protonation states. The results table shows different protonation states if hydrogen atoms are present in at least one of the input models. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any questions, contact us at help@phoenix-online.org or tutorials@phoenix-online.org.